Now we will solve our question number 3. A piece of a copper having a rectangular cross section of 15.2 mm and 19.1 mm is pulled in tension with a 44,500 newton force producing only elastic deformation. Calculate the resulting strain. Shear modulus of elasticity of a copper is 142 × 10⁻⁹ newton per meter square. You can observe that in this question, area is given, that is given as 15.2. So 15.2 × 19.1. We can express this in terms of meter, that means 10⁻⁶ m². So this is the area of cross section, 15.2 mm × 19.1 mm. So we are expressing in terms of meter. Now force acting is given. You can observe that force is also given. So 44,500 newton force is acting. Shear modulus is also given. So shear modulus is given as 42 × 10⁹ n·m². So 42 × 10⁹ n·m². So we are supposed to calculate strain acting. So strain. You know, when I consider this case of shear modulus. So shear modulus is given as a shearing stress divided by shearing strain. So here we are supposed to find this strain on this. Shearing strain only we are supposed to find. So we can express this as a, you can observe that the strain. So strain only we are supposed to find. So that is expressed as a stress divided by this G, that means shear modulus we can mention. So we can calculate this strain as stress means F by A only. So we can write this equation as F by A into G. So this is the way we can calculate this value of strain. All the values are given. We just substitute this. So we are getting this strain as F is given, 44,500. Divided by area we are expressing in terms of a meter, that means you can observe that 15.2 × 19.1 × 10⁻⁶ into G is also given, that means 42 × 10⁹. We are doing this, so you will get this answer for strain. So you will get this answer as you can observe that we are getting this answer as 3.65 × 10⁻³. We are getting. So we are getting this answer as 3.65 × 10⁻³. So we are getting this strain as 3.65 × 10⁻³. A rigid bar of mass 15 kg is supported symmetrically by 3 wires, each of 2 meters long. These at each end are copper and the middle one is iron. Determine the ratio of the diameters if each is to have the same tension. So you can observe that this is a question. So there is a rod is suspended with the help of 3 wires. Like this, you can answer there are 3 wires which is used to suspend this rod. In this way, you can answer the case of the rod. So it is suspended with the help of 3 wires. So you can observe that in this at the each end copper wire is middle one is considered as iron. So middle one is considered as iron, and at the each end we can see that the copper wire is at the each end. So this is where you can answer part. And here you can observe that this tension acting on this wire is the same. So tension acting. The tension acting on this wire is the same means the extension produced on the wire is also same. And they are having same length. So we can say that the L of length of each wire is the same. Length of each wire is the same. And extension is also remains the same. Because tension acting on each wire is the same. Tension means the force acting on each wire is the same. So you can observe this in this question, we are supposed to find what is the ratio of this diameter of each wire. In this question you can observe that Young's modulus of elasticity of a copper and iron is given. So Young's modulus of a copper is given as Young's modulus of a copper is given. You can observe that there is a 110 into 10 raised to 9 newton per meter square. Similarly, Young's modulus of iron is also given. So that is 190 into 10 raised to 9 newton per meter square. Length of each wire is given. Length is given as, you can observe that is given as 2 meter long. Length of each wire is given as 2 meter long. So you have to find, determine the ratio of the diameters of each of these wire. There is the same tension is acting on this wire. So we have to find this ratio of this diameter. Suppose we are taking this ratio as, we are going to find this diameter of a copper to diameter of this iron. So this ratio only we are going to find. You know, when we are considering this equation, Young's modulus is given as V naught. So this value is given as F by A divided by delta A divided by L. That means Young's modulus we can mention as FL divided by A into delta L. So this way we can mention the case of this Young's modulus. And here we can observe that area we can mention in terms of area we can mention in terms of pi r square. So we can modify this equation. That means Young's modulus we can mention as FL divided by pi r square. That means V by 2 all square into delta L we can mention. That means our equation becomes, you can see that in this case. Our equation becomes, we can simplify this, 4 is coming. So Young's modulus, general equation you can see that. So 4 FL divided by pi B square into delta L is R. So this is the way we are getting this general equation for this Young's modulus. So y is equal to Young's modulus is equal to 4 FL divided by pi B square into delta L. Can observe this equation. We have seen that L, delta L, F, all these things are same in the case of a ball, copper wire and iron. That means Young's modulus is depends only on diameter. You can say that Young's modulus is inversely proportional to this diameter, E square. So if you are taking this, if you want to find this ratio of this copper and iron, that only we are going to find. What is the ratio of diameter of a copper and the iron? So you can observe that in this case, this ratio is coming. We can mention this as d square is proportional, or d is we can write proportional to 1 by root Young's modulus, we can mention root y we can mention. So this is where you can see that. That means if you want to find this ratio as a diameter of this copper to diameter of this iron, that means you can observe that this becomes under root of Young's modulus of iron divided by Young's modulus of copper is. So this way you can mention our equation. So diameter of copper divided by diameter of iron we can calculate as under root of Young's modulus of iron is equal. You can see this equation. 190 into 10 raised to 9 divided by Young's modulus of copper is 1. That is 110 into 10 raised to 9. So you can neglect some of these things. So equation becomes under root of 90 divided by 11. So you can calculate this value. So you will get this answer as 1.3 under root of 90 by 11. So this ratio between the diameter of copper to this iron is coming as 1.3.